السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وبه نستعين ونصلي ونسلم على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا وإمامنا محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن سلك طريقهم وسار على نهجهم ودعا بدعوتهم إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، يقول الله تبارك وتعالى: فهل ينظرون إلا الساعة أن تأتيهم بغتة فقد جاء أشراطها فأنى لهم إذا جاءتهم ذكراهم فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله. صدق الله العظيم. Honorable ulama of this blessed city, the historic ancient city wherein Islam has commenced in this beautiful country, the city of Cape Town. Honored ulama, beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, what is the greatest gift we have? I have already heard an answer from the crowd. Iman. Iman in what? Iman in Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, belief in the unseen and the fact that we have been chosen by our names, my name, your name, to be from the ummah of the one whose name is the greatest, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of creation, afdalul khalqi wa akramur rusuli, the best of creation without a split doubt, higher than any angel that can ever exist, higher than Jibril alayhi salatu wa salam, the most honored of all the anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam. Are we not honored to have been chosen to be from amongst his ummah? Wallahi, if we do not feel this honor, there is something wrong with us. If we do not feel the bond that we have with one another, the common factor that we have between us, the shahadatul islami wal iman, if we do not feel the bond with one another because of that kalima, there is something wrong with us. The kalima we share is the greatest gift we ever have and anyone would ever have. Wallahi, if you have food and drink and air, but you do not have the shahada, you have nothing. And if you do not have food, no drink, no air, no clothing, no accommodation, but you have kalimatul haqq, wallahi, you have the solution for the dunya and the akhirah. Wallahi, you have been given something that no one has ever been given. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. That is my ticket to Jannah. That is your ticket to Jannah. Wallahi, if you don't have that ticket, you stand no chance to enter Jannah. So let us utter in chorus, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. That is the driving force between ourselves and our iman. That is the driving force between us and Jannah. Wallahi, thumma wallah, if you lose that, you have lost everything. And if you have that, you have everything. May Allah grant us the ability to hold fast to it. It is the only thing we have that we can be granted hope through. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast on that shahada. May He grant us death with La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah as the last words before we leave. Man kana akhiru kalamihi min ad-dunya La ilaha illallah dakhala al-jannah. The hadith explains itself. Whomsoever has uttered these words as the last words before they leave will definitely enter Jannah. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Abu Talib, the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was about to leave this dunya, he refused to accept Islam and Iman. So he had everything, but he did not have the ticket to enter Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at him and said, Ya Ammi, قُلْ كَلِمَةً أُحَاجُّ لَكَ بِهَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Oh my uncle, utter with your tongue, just utter one sentence, one statement, and I will fight your case on the day of Qiyamah. Just utter the term, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, we not gifted? Wallahi, Allah knows you personally. Today, if the president happened to know you personally, the people would regard you as someone very important. But wallahi, why do we forget the fact that Allah knows you by name, wallah? And He knows everything about you. He knows you personally. He loves you, Allah. He is waiting for you to turn to Him. What is the best day you can ever have? The best day you can have is the day you return to the Allah that created you. Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. Tuhfatul Mu'min il Maut. The gift of a true believer is death, because that is when he will have no more oppression, no more problems. That La ilaha illallah, which he believed in, will become the yaqeen. He will see it on that day and he will see the benefit of it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the benefit on that particular day. I wish to raise before you the preparation for that day and a few signs that have occurred and will occur regarding the coming of that day. Remember one thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Inna ajal Allahi idha jaa la yuakhkhar. Indeed, when the fixed and prescribed time of Allah regarding yourselves and regarding anything and everything, when it comes, it will not be delayed. إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهُمْ فَلَا يَسْتَأْخِرُونَ سَاعَةً وَلَا يَسْتَقْدِمُونَ. When the fixed hour of anyone comes, they will not be able to bring it or to delay it even by a split moment, nor to bring it forward even by a split moment. Your time is written. My time is written. Don't be fooled. Every breath you are taking is one breath closer to that time. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There are signs of Qiyamah, my dear brothers and sisters. The signs of Qiyamah are many. Some of them are good, some of them are bad. When we say some of them are good, we mean they are encouraging on their own, but they are worth being concerned about and worth being pondering over when it comes to discussing them and connecting them to Qiyamah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's very advent, the fact that he came was already a sign of Qiyamah. He said, Bu'ithtu ana was-sa'a kahataini. I have been sent as close to Qiyamah as this. And he pointed with the two fingers. No other Nabi could do that, because each Nabi was sent and another Nabi was going to come after him. But when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent, who was going to come after him? No other Nabi. Ana khatamun nabiyyina la nabiyya ba'di. I am the final messenger. There is going to be no messenger after me. Anyone coming to you telling you that I am a messenger of Allah, they are lying. But if they tell you I am a messenger of the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are speaking the truth. If someone comes to you and says, I have brought to you the message of the messenger, they are telling the truth. If they have come to you with haqq, the ulama are regarded as warathatul anbiya. They are the heirs of the anbiya alayhim salatu wassalam, because they went in to see what the anbiya left and they took from that particular estate, if I can call it, of the anbiya alayhim salatu wassalam. But if someone comes to you and says, I'm a nabi, as is happening today, then indeed they are lying. We need to stay far away from them. So the first sign of the coming of Qiyamah was the very advent of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because after him there is no Nabi. There will rather be Qiyamah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us peace on that day.